تسليم الكثير. كيف الحال؟ أصبحتم؟ كيف أصبحتم؟ الحمد لله، الحمد لله، في نعمة من الله وفضل، الحمد لله رب العالمين. أستاذ الود بوك أوف رياض الصالحين and the section of الصدق truthfulness، may الله عز وجل make us among الصادقين، آمين رب العالمين. And we were with the حديث of أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه، حديث متفق عليه صحيح البخاري ومسلم، حديث narrated by أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told us about one of the prophets before, prophet one of the prophets of Bani Israel who was making jihad في سبيل الله, who was fighting for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And when he was preparing his army, he asked his people, or he told his people, or he declared to his people that three categories of people will not join us in this expedition or in this ghazwa. One is the person that he make aqd al-nikah on a woman and he had not consummated the marriage. He has not consummated the marriage. So this one does not come with us. And the number two, a person who built the walls of a house and about to put the roof, then also this person does not join us. And a person who bought, you know, camel, she camels or sheep, and he's waiting for them to deliver. They're pregnant, they're waiting for them to deliver. Also, this person does not join us. And then he went fi sabilillah, those people did not join. And then when they reached to the town or the village that they are going to fight with the residents of, the Asr time came in. So he looked at the sun and he said, Allah knows, I am ordered and you are ordered. And you are ordered to go in a certain course and I'm ordered to go in a certain course. I'm ordered to do this and you are ordered to send. Then he asked Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Allah, ihbisha alayna. Ya Allah, keep it from setting for a while until we finish this. Because if the night comes, then we have a problem, right? These people. Then Allah Azza wa Jal did that. Fahubisat. So the sun stopped. حتى فتح الله عليه until Allah عز وجل opened for him. انتصر يعني he won الحمد لله. حتى فتح الله عليه فجمع الغنائم, so he gathered the spoils of war. غنائم is the plural of غنيمة. غنم يغنم غنائم, so he's gathered all the spoils of war and it was the order of Allah سبحانه وتعالى that for them to know that Allah accepted their action, their fighting, their jihad, their deed, is that a fire will come from the sky and burn it. So that means it's accepted. That's what happened for the sons of Adam. فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا وَلَمْ يُتَقَبِّلْ مِنَ الْآخَرِ. قبول is based, or the acceptance is based on a fire devouring it. So you don't have any share in it. So that means what were you doing? You were doing it for Allah's sake only. So the fire came but did not touch it. So Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فجاءت لتأكلها فلم تطعمها, يعني did not touch it, did not take it. فقال النبي, that prophet said, إن فيكم غلولا. إن فيكم غلولا, يعني you have this act of غلول. غل يغل غلولا. وما كان لنبي أن يغل, يعني a prophet will not make a غلول. غلول means keeping something before the division. So it is the right of someone to be divided in a certain way, the prescription, and then a person keeps a share. That's called غلول. Right? That's called what? غلول means you keep it close to you, right? And that's why الغل also is your grudge inside of the heart. It's eating the heart from inside. And it's also غل. الغل also is the cuffs that the person. ولا تجعل يدك مغلولة إلى عنق. Everything that you keep close to you or tight, it is from that root of the word, right? That word, or you find غين and لام anywhere, like going around like this, you, all derivatives and all that, it will give you the indication of something tight, something close to you, not shared. Right? So he said, فيكم الغلول, you have that غلول among you. فليبايعني من كل قبيلة الرجل. So from every tribe of Ben Israel, one man gives me pledge, بايعه. Right? So they give a representative from each tribe, and each one give him the bay'ah, يعني by Allah, we're not the ones. By Allah, we're not the ones. By Allah, we're not the ones. Until one of them, his hand stuck to the hand of the Prophet. He could not take it out. قال فيكم الغلام. It's your tribe. فلزقت يد رجل بيده فقال فيكم الغلول. So now it is, instead of the whole army, became a one tribe. So it is known. Now this man has to go to his tribe and find out exactly what it is. Subhanallah. طبعاً, there is a hadith also, it says, فَلَزِقَتْ يَدُ رَجُلَيْنِ أَوْ ثَلَاثَ بِيَدِهِ. So it's not only one. It is two or three of the tribes. Right? فَلَزِقَتْ يَدُ رَجُلَيْنِ أَوْ ثَلَاثَ بِيَدِهِ. فَقَالَ فِيكُمُ الْغُلُولِ. It is in you. فَجَاءُوا, so they went, بِمِثْلِ, فَجَاءُوا بِرَأْسٍ مِثْلِ رَأْسِ بَقَرَةٍ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ. So they came with a head like a head of a cow made out of gold. And all of them were into this, right? فَوَضَعَهَا, so he put it on the rest of the spoils of war. فَجَاءَتِ النَّارُ فَأَكَلَتْهَا. So the fire came and accepted. So now, yes. فَلَمْ تَحِلَّ الْغَنَائِمُ لِأَحَدٍ قَبْلَنَا. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم says, this spoils of war was not halal for anybody before us. We are the first one. ثُمَّ أَحَلَّ اللَّهُ لَنَا الْغَنَائِمَ لَمَّا رَأَى ضَعْفَنَا وَعَجْزَنَا فَأَحَلَّهَا لَنَا. صلى الله على رسول الله. Then Allah عز وجل made it halal for us when he saw our weakness and our disability. So Allah عز وجل give it to us. You see the rahmah of Allah to this ummah? So sometimes a hadith like this makes you wonder. Because whenever you give an order to someone, they consider it very hard. But when it is compared to someone else, then you know the hikmah of it. يعني مثلا, example, if a najasa comes in your clothes, يعني some impurities, what do? You go wash it. صح? Right? So some people say, oh, I just go wash my clothes, I do this, it becomes like water. You know, it's big. But you know, in the nations before, whenever a najasa comes, you got to cut that part out of your clothes. You got to cut it. And then either you throw that piece of clothes, or if you need it, you have to put another. So it's not good anywhere. Can you imagine that? Huh? Can you imagine this? So now you just sprinkle some water. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. You see the rahmah of Allah. When you, if somebody commit shirk, and someone commit shirk, أشرك بالله والعز بالله. This is big. And if he does, go to hellfire, right? But if he comes and repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, what does he do or she? What does he or she would do? Just repent. Right? Just repent and come back. You know, in the nations before, they have to kill themselves. Literally. Literally. And it's not like figuratively. Yeah. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when his people worshipped the cow when he was in Mountain Fattur, and he comes back and he finds them this. You know why he was very mad? He was very mad. Everybody think he took it personally. Yeah. He knows what is the punishment for this. Yeah, he knows big problem happening now. How are we going to fix this now? Right? فَأَلْقَى الْأَلْوَاحِ. He threw it. وَأَخَذَ بِرَأْسِ أَخِيهِ. Why you let this happen like this? So he said, well, I tried and did this and that. And you know, you tried, you know the story. Then, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنَّكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. You transgress yourself. إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَإِيهِ ظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنَّكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ بِاتِّخَاذِكُمْ الْعِجْلِ. You transgressed yourself by worshipping that. فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ فَاقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. So you have to repent to your Lord, so kill yourselves. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم telling us became very dark on them, and each one holding a dagger, and they started going with each other. So those who died, their tawbah is accepted because they surrendered themselves. And those who did not die, they accepting that. So Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam started, you know, bleeding to Allah, Ya Allah, Yafna bani Israel, Allah, they will finish all of them. Ya Allah, please you stop, you know, this for our, your Rahman, all that. Then Allah said, that's it, finish. After tens of thousands, they were dropping on the ground. Now, when you or me commit a sin, and you know that the road between you and the repentance is just raising your hand, or going sajda, or doing two rak'ah, you appreciate, right? You appreciate the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you go on and on like that. Whenever the father or the mother tell you to do something, then you have to understand it is very, very simple. Subhanallah. When you do the salah, when you read the Quran, you know that this sharia and the deen of Islam is a refinement of very big issues and hard things. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, he said to his people that I came with the Injil to make it easy for you. وَلِأُحِلَّ لَكُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي حُرِّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ. And I come for to make halal for you few of the things that that was haram for you before. Make it easy for you. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even more. رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. How Allah sent a prophet as rahma lil'alameen without a deen which is not rahma lil'alameen. Everything, and that's why Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, هذه الشريعة, this is the deen of Allah, this sharia of Allah, رحمة كلها وعدل كلها, you know, all of it is justice, all of it is mercy, all of it is goodness. So never think it is just a duty on you to do, it is actually to refine you as a human being, to make you more beneficial and make you better. So this hadith here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when Allah knows our weakness, knew our weakness, He make it halal for us what was haram for the people before. They are tough, they are rude, they are making it hard for themselves, so Allah make it hard on them. But when we surrender to Allah Azza wa Jal, we make sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we accept the deen of Allah, Allah make things easy for us. So the more you accept, the easier the deen becomes. The more you reject, the harder it becomes. No? This is a rule, physics. You know, you push something, it pushes against you. Same force. Yeah, I have a ball, you hit the wall, it will come at you and hit you very hard. So if you reject the deen, it becomes harder on you. Because Rasulullah said, إِنَّ هَذَا الدِّينَ يُسْرٌ وَلَنْ يُشَدَّ الدِّينَ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا غَلَبَهُ. And if you fight with the deen, struggle like against it to reject or feel it is heavy, it will become heavier on you. That's why الصلاه, Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٍ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. Think about this ayah. Salah is big, is hard, is heavy, except عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. So what الْخَاشِعِينَ? They soften and they surrender to this salah, which is a big thing. Once they surrender, the salah becomes not kabira on them. But if they don't surrender in the salah, salah is just a duty, it is very heavy. Going to the masjid, waking up, car, driving, changing, driving, going to the masjid and praying. And then for what? Sheikh stand 10 minutes in the salah. Why just pray here? Kabira, it became a big thing when you look at it that way. But al-khashi'een, subhanallah, 1 minute standing in front of Allah equals this world. Start my day with just 1 minute in front of Allah, even standing there with soft heart. I said, Alhamdulillah, this is what, that feeling that stays with me for a few minutes is worth it. Then you're kind of excited. All the efforts that you put, you're enjoying. And then when you come, mashallah, you know, you go there. And many people, subhanallah, sacrifice more for less. Think about it. You sacrifice more for what? For less. You go on your favorite restaurant. Favorite restaurant. You make a reservation ahead of time. And sometimes you go to a restaurant, you find people lining up. You're standing there. For what? What? Yani what? Plate. A human being cooks it. Yeah. But there is something in your head, right? That this is worth it. This is different. These eggs are laid by a special chicken, yani. Right? These eggs are laid by special chicken. They have special pepper and special salt. Yeah, معلش, we think like that, right? So after it passes your tongue, you know what happens to it. It's all in that part. You know, this. That's it. So once it passes this, خلاص, alhamdulillah. No good smell, no good looks, no good feeling, no good everything. All right, so but we stand in that line. And then you wait to be seated. And you will accept any table. Because it's crowded. You're lucky and you feel so good that you achieved it. And then when you sit there and they bring up, give this note to the chef. Thank you, chef. Right? And then you eat and you enjoy and then you say, MashaAllah, I had a very good breakfast today in such and such place. Shuftu, I'm just giving you what you sacrifice for. A plate of food for Allah's sake. You sacrifice all this effort. A movie, you sacrifice this effort. A game, you sacrifice too much effort and you cancel many things and all of that. Game and a TV. People making millions of dollars to play, huh? And we give money for them to play. And we just sit there and have fun looking. But for dars, for salah, for sitting 1 hour after fajr, that's not for everyone. Illa alal khashi'in. May Allah make us among them. Now you know what to ask Allah, right? Allahumma ij'alni min al-khashi'in. So now you know key. There is a key, right? When Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "Innama yataqabbalu Allahu min al-muttaqin." Only Allah accepts. Allah accepts only from muttaqin. Then what you should ask Allah? Allahumma ij'alni min al, right? Wallahu yuhibbu al-muhsinin. Allah loves al-muhsinin. Allahumma ij'alni min al. Here you go. Read the Quran and find those keys. And then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah gives you more knowledge. So this hadith is telling us the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also this hadith is telling us or giving us a sign of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's prophethood. Because how he gets these stories from the nations before. Also this hadith telling us that you have things in your life or you have affairs in your life to help you survive as a human being and to help you as a Muslim to focus on your deen. If they become distractions, then you have a problem. That's why that prophet said those three people, because their mind will be distracted, because their heart is attached to something else. So their heart is attached to something else. And subhanAllah, he said, don't come with us. But see, akhwana, at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he finishes the battle of Uhud, and he finds one of the Sahaba, subhanAllah, as if he's profusely sweating. And then he says, this is, Malaika is washing his body. Taban, shaheed, you don't wash the body, right? But the Malaika was doing that. And then he asks, and he finds that it was his wedding night last night. He was just consummated the marriage last night. And then in the morning when Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam invited, he went and fought fi sabilillah. You see the difference between this Ummah and the Ummah before. You know, so they, our Ummah, subhanAllah, the Sahaba of Rasulullah showed us that they enjoy this world, but when the deen of Allah comes, that enjoyment is like a vehicle to take them to the purpose, to serve the cause, is not a distraction. You see, the real believer, Allah is not telling you or telling us as Muslims to abandon the mata' of the dunya, but don't let it distract you. So before, you have, no, you stay away. Okay? But here, no, you join, and it's based on your niyyah, subhanAllah. So we have that balance. This ummah has the balance. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. You have balance in everything. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الدنيا متاع وخير متاعها الزوجة الصالحة أو المرأة الصالحة. This dunya is an enjoyment and the best of enjoyment is a pious righteous wife. Subhanallah. You see? So this is the, enjoy life, enjoy that relationship. Have love, have romance, no problem. But if it comes to the service of Allah, make that not to clash. This hadith is telling us it was will clash, right? But in our hadith it says it will not clash. It should carry you to more. That's why you choose the right spouse. Because you know that good relationship we are enjoying, it makes us better Muslims. Not the opposite. That's why when I go to Hajj every year, subhanAllah, when I find a young couple who just got married and coming for Hajj, I love that. And I go and tell them, Wallahi jazakumullah khayran, may Allah reward you, may Allah give you blessing in your life, because you want to start like that. How many people would do that? See, they want to enjoy their life and start in a good note with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we supposed to make dua for them that Allah make their life continue like this. You understand? It's not distraction. Because distraction when we got married, is it Hawaii or Belize or you know Cancun, which one? Right? But someone says, la, la, la. Allah blessed us with this, we go thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have the money, Umrah or Hajj first. Then we can go enjoy this one too. No problem. It's not haram to go, but you see it's all about what is in your head and what is in your heart. So no distraction. Don't make the enjoyment and the happiness of this life distract you from the deen of Allah. Actually make it a vehicle or something that carries you to serve the deen of Allah. Right? You enjoy your money, make it a way for you to serve Allah. So portion of it is for zakah, portion of it is for sadaqah, portion of it is to make your house better, portion of it is to teach your kids Al-Quran and the deen. Yeah? Otherwise, what is the money for? Yeah? What do we make the money for at the end of the day? Ask yourself, subhanAllah, in the last 10 years I've been saving this much. How much of this saving, what is the percentage of this saving that you did for Allah Azza wa Jal? Forget about the zakah, it's a duty, right? But how much of that money, what is the percentage? You know, we all think about the percentage of the money that makes, and I want to invest in this, and I want to invest in that, and this is going to bring me 2%, and it's going to make me 12%, and if I do this money, everybody wants the like what I get out of this, right? But imagine now you are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you get that question. All right, you saved $100,000 over the past 10 years, مثلاً, yeah. How much of this $100,000 was fi sabili, in my cause, yeah? How much you did? What can you say? If you don't know the percentage, I mean, see, it's all about the frame of mind, right? Like when you wake up in the morning, you said, how much I'm going to spend for Allah today? $10? 10? I'll just put $10 in the box of the masjid. I feel good about it. I did my duty now. I'm going to put like a few coins in the hand of a homeless. What is it exactly? Right? Or I want to put something visible in the masjid so I can see it every time that I made this. So what is it? Ask. SubhanAllah. Ask. This is questions we should ask ourselves as exercise, right? So what is the percentage of this amal? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, sahih, that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his sahaba, he said, ayyukum مال ورثته أحب إليه من ماله. Who among you loves or the money that you have control over? I mean the money that your ears have control over is dearer to you than the money that you have control over. They said, nobody. Everybody wants the money that they have control over. Even when you want to leave the money for your ears, you're going to say what happens, right? You want to say what happens. That's the control, right? It's not like, oh, I love the money to be in the hand of my children, right? But you want to make sure that it is in the hand of, it's control, right? You don't want somebody else to decide for you. Even though Allah made the Sharia and said what? Some people always come to me all the time and say, what if I do this? And what if I do that? What if I do this? It's good to know. But this coming out of a feeling of what? You want to know what, you want to have control over what happens in a good way, right? In a good way, not in a negative way. So they said, so Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فَمَالُ أَحَدِكُمْ مَا قَدَّمْ وَمَالُ وَرَثَتِهِ مَا أَخَرْ. Your money is what you spend. That's your money. And what you save is not your money. Remember this rule of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The money which is in the bank, you open your phone now and access your bank account. look at it. What you're looking at now, that's not yours. You think you are, it's yours. You know, when I open up, checking, saving, you know, the good. That's mine, right? No. Rasulullah said, this is not yours. Any money you're keeping is not yours. Because you can die today, and what happens? With someone else. Actually, as we're speaking, all the money in the bank is not yours. Somebody else is benefiting from it while you are sleeping. Sahih or not? It's moving around in the economy and the door, you know. So people are working it, mashallah. And our money collectively is making millions, not necessarily for us collectively. Think about it. Am I right or am I exaggerating here? So this money collectively, a community here of champion, they have money in the bank. Each one is looking at himself or herself only. So this is my bank, $50,000, $3,000, $100, whatever it is. So collectively, these people of this masjid, mashallah, Rabbul Alameen, how many millions they can have? Am Sheikh Mufu, how many millions can this community have in the bank account collectively? Give a number, Kidal. Yal, go ahead. Let's say that there is 2,000 people, they are in this masjid. 2,000 people in this masjid, they come for Jumu'ah. 2,000 people, average what? We put average what? 10,000? 10? $5,000? Maashi, Amu, $5,000 average. Some people have $100, some people have $10 million. Only 5,000. Even though the average is not fair, يعني, but 5,000. 5,000 times 2,000. Are you sure? $5,000 times 2,000, huh? This $10 million? This $10 million is الوقت in the bank. We are sitting in the masjid or sleeping or doing nothing. Today is Sunday, huh? So this $10 million is just waiting for you in a safe, kid, locked in a safe, stacked money? Yes or no? Mm, no. So what is it doing now, the $10 million?
Working for bank.
Is it coming for benefit for you? Yani there is benefit? This money working on Sunday yani, in the system. Is it coming benefit to you?
Zero.
So whose money is this? Yours, right? Is your money? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, right? You know which one is your money? That $10 you put in the box. That has your name on it. It does have your name on it. The money you spend to eat breakfast, that has your name on it. The money you spend for your child or your spouse, that has your name on it. The money that you planted the tree in your front yard with it, that's your money. The money you spend to the guy who cut your grass, that's your money. So the money has your name on it, that has gone out of your hand. Now it is your money. Why? Because nobody can change that. It came out from you, means it is written on you. Well, good or bad? وَمَالُ أَحَدِكُمْ مَا قَدَّمْ يعني the money is that what you give. Once it comes out, it comes out from your hand, it is your money. Before that, it's not guaranteed. طبعاً, I give you just a tip of the iceberg, this understanding. Yeah. You can go, mashallah, on a whole session on telling you how horrible it is. Yeah. How very, very bad in it, to the point that we became part of a machine, yeah, right? That gives, you know, تعرفون the ox that keeps going blind and it keeps going like the mill. Huh? What is the ox doing? For what? What is the benefit the ox getting? Yeah, yeah, he's getting some grass to be put in the mouth. But what did the ox achieve? Lots of ground grains and all of that, right? Going someone else. Congratulations, Mr. Ox. All right? So it's just like that. There's one of the scholars who know yani, the system very well. He said, yani, mashallah, we look at the advertisement and we go buy things left and right from Amazon, from this, from that. Feeling good, right? That I'm buying. I have the money and I'm buying and I'm ordering and thing package comes in front of you and all of that, all of those things, you know, like amazing. It feels good that I have money and I'm buying. I have money, my money, and I am buying things. But you know who was just advertised and sold? It's you. You were advertised and you were sold. Right? Every single day, you're sold every single day. You go on Facebook, right? And you are the product. We are the product now. It's not the product that you buy. This is not the product. I am the product. You know how I am the product? Because I was led to it. Right? My email was given. My information was given. Then I started being targeted. So I am the product. I'm being purchased. It's big, a little bit deeper, right? But that's the fact. We're the product. It's like we are, you know, when you go to the zoo, you look at the animals, right? But actually reverse it. Maybe the animals are looking at us. They're standing together, waiting for the humans coming every day. Look at this miserable guy. Look at this miserable lady. Look at this couple pretending to be in love. Look at think about it, that you know the animals are stationed and we are like the ones who are being reviewed. We look at them in the cage, but maybe they are looking at us on another level completely, right? Yeah, so it's all in here. So subhanAllah, we are going to the mall and going to all this, but you are the one who is being sold like a slave, yeah, right? You know, you go in this station, grab your money and here, take this. And grab your money and here. And that's what we do all day long. MashaAllah, Rabbul Alameen. I told you, if we talk about like this, you will see the value. Real value in this material world, we are nobody. We are nobody. And you have to purchase. There is no way that you will not purchase. Allah Azza wa Jal is giving us the karama. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. You have your value. If that's what people do to me, رب العالمين told me you are higher. رب العالمين told me pray and I'll put you higher. رب العالمين said read Quran and you go higher. Follow رسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم and you go higher. Love each other and you have a better value. Money is serving you. You are not serving the money. Money is under your control. You are not under its control. And so on, right? See the beauty of the deen of Islam? It is like that. So subhanAllah, the sunnah of Rasulullah is teaching us that. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam told us that this prophet told the sun to stop. Now some people might take this as, how come this happened? The sun has to go on its course. The moon has to go. What are you talking about? Again, what is that person missing here? He's focusing on what is happening, not who is making it happen. Right? So when you attribute to Allah who is making this happen, then you rest assured. Our belief, our faith. Who makes the sun, who made the sun go in its course like this? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So isn't he able, logically, isn't he able to reverse that course? Is he able to change that course? Is he able to make exemption or exception for that course? Absolutely. So what is the big deal? When you deal with Allah, everything is possible. The one who makes the system that beautiful and that tight, Allah, he can change subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we benefit from this, the responsibility of the leader. He said, from each tribe, I want one person. Right? So that's why when you are led, you have to trust the leader. And when you are a leader, you have to be responsible about whom you're leading. كُلُّكُمْ رَاعٍ وَكُلُّكُمْ مَسْؤُولٌ. Everyone is responsible. And you see, when they went back, they were able to bring what is, they care. Even though the person himself is not the one who make the ghulul, but it is in your family, it is in your people. And please, if somebody nicely give the nasiha for you or your for you about your family, accept it. Accept it. Don't be offended. And if somebody tells you to help them something because wrong that came out of you intentionally or unintentionally, don't feel offended. I'll give you an example, small little example. You know, on our deen, Rasulullah SAW said, وَالْعَيْنُ حَقٌّ and hasad and envy is haq. Right? Now, when someone comes to me and said, Ya Shaykh, I'm feeling tired, I'm feeling this, go to the doctor. And I went to the doctor and everything is fine, but I'm feeling exhausted and feeling not myself and all that. So he said, we can do the ruqya, but what happened to you in the past few days when you start feeling like this? Oh, I was in this party, or I was in this wedding, or I was in that. And then you go on and on until you know that somebody give some, without saying mashallah, laqat al-ibla, saying some word of Allah. So it happens. And it happens not from bad people. Al-ayn can happen from good people too. Yani we assume that you are accused, yani, right? I can give ayn to somebody. It happens, subhanallah. So, said, ask that person, as Rasulullah asked the other Sahabi, who did the same with another Sahabi. He told him, make the wudu, do the wudu, and get the water in a container, and then wash the inner part of your izhar, or your clothes, yani, which touches your stomach. Yani. Wash it with water and squeeze it in that same container and give it to that person to put over their head, and alhamdulillah will be shifa. This is hadith in Sahih Bukhari, right? So, but I cannot go tell that person that. I cannot go tell that person. Sheikh, انت عايزه يموتني? يعني, he give me the eye. Now if I go, he's going to kill me. Or punch me in the face. What are you saying? أنا حسد, my eye is evil, استغفر. And then they will hit each other. The sunnah of Rasulullah, if somebody asking you for that, do it without asking. Do it. Because this is your help to your Muslim brother. Even if they are assuming, maybe you are not the one. They just think you are the one. Right? Sometimes think they are the one. They're not sure. If someone, wallahi, comes and asks this whole masjid to do it, the whole masjid should do it. No big deal. No problem. What I'm trying to say here is, don't assume bad about others, and don't take someone asking you for help or someone telling you that you did something wrong is like a bad thing for you. Actually, it's a good thing for you. It's better to fix it here, not there. Because you know we'll be accounted for that too. In Yawm al-Qiyamah, we'll be accounted for that too. Yeah, so it is that as well. So when a leader asking people to fix something, they should willingly fix it. Don't take it personal and say why, how, this, that. And then it becomes an issue. Shayateen take over, right? It becomes an issue. Khalas, alhamdulillah, tell me if it isn't me, I fix it. Jazakallah khair. Allah reward you. No problem. Also, from this hadith, from this hadith, we know the mu'jizat of Allah. So this was a mu'jiza or a miracle for that prophet, as Rasulullah got similar when they told him make the moon split, and he made the moon split. They said, oh, he make magic to our eyes. He sahara ayunana Muhammad. Subhanallah, you asked for something and he did it exactly what you want. See, logically it is not acceptable. And logically it's not acceptable when you tell somebody, what does it take for me to do it, for you to? He said, I want such and such. Well, I give you that what you just asked. And you say, oh, this is one of your tricks. Yeah, you asked me. And I give you what you asked me. And it becomes one of my tricks. Yani, if you know that it can be a trick, why you asked for it? Fahimtum? Yani, you understand how? They said, we will not believe until you split the moon. If I split the moon, you believe? Yes. So it is not a trick in your head. You, in your head now, until now, it is something big. If it happens, yes. And when it happens, you should say, I agree now. Alhamdulillah. But now, saying it is a trick, that's your excuse not to believe. That means when you asked in the beginning, it was not for the purpose. It was to play. It's to play. And we do that, by the way, in our daily affairs. Sometimes as I was saying the khutbah and the durus, sometimes we project things. So, you know, whenever you hear a crime or a problem, you say, everybody can do this, but not me. But look carefully, and you will find that you are doing it on a different level. Yeah. It's a smaller level, but it is it's doable. So someone comes, and, مثلاً in Egypt, في عندنا حاجة اسمها كده routine, يعني red tab, you know, the red tab, that government offices and all that. So you go to the guy to get a birth certificate, a copy of a birth certificate. How hard is this? Yani over here, mashallah, in America, you kind of go online and it kind of you complain, internet is not working, it's slow website, this is our complaints over here, right? Ah, mashallah alik. So تعال بقى أوديك أنا عندنا. Come and I will show you how it happens over there. And one time I go to Egypt, I stayed 1 month vacation to get one piece of paper, and I did not get it. Until now, 20 years, يعني. والله I did not get it. That one paper, piece, one paper. And the guy can just, تفضل. خد روح. That's it. That's what he has to do. But you go and say, give me a form of ID. طب أنا I'm coming for this paper to get an ID. I want the Egyptian ID and they are asking me to get your form of ID. Why I'm coming here? So ask me for something. Okay, you go get him whatever, right? Your father's birth certificate. They said, okay, get me your graduation certificate. طب قلتش لي امبارح, why did not tell me yesterday? هو that's what it is, right? So you come next day and having that service, oh no, you have to neutralize it. You have to go in the office and neutralize it. Yahi, anything else? La la la, that's it. Then, you know, you come and he's not there. He's not there. Where is the ustaz of the, oh, he just went for salah. Ya salam al khushu'a. Allahu Akbar on the piety and righteousness. And then you wait. Okay, after coming to Salah, may Allah accept your Salah. Alhamdulillah, Allah. Then he said, all this paper said, oh, mashallah, everything good. Now go to the mudir to sign it for you. You go for the mudir, oh, he's off for the day. He's off for the day, right? So I'm sitting with you and you are reviewing. تعرف أن المدير, he's going to leave in 5 minutes. So the whole point here is what? For my paper to finish? That's what is in his head, Yani? What is in his head? He doesn't want me to be there. He just want me to give up. So that's the real issue here. But every time he's asking me for something, it is not toward finishing this deal. Because if finishing this deal is the goal, like I want to finish my deal, and if he as an employee want to finish my deal, it will finish the first time. You know why? That I just have to call or I have to go, if you want this paper, this is what you need. You go get him one time and done, go. If the whole idea is to finish the maslaha of the human being, but the whole idea is not to finish the maslaha of the human being. And the other thing is, there is another way to finish it fast. You know the way, right? Now I had to take 1 month to understand that, because I was dumb يعني, and didn't know that's how you speed things up. But when I know, I was shocked. I said, مش عايزها. I don't want that paper. I don't want that paper. And until now, I don't have that paper. That is missing in my file. That piece of paper missing in my file. You know, that piece of paper, عشان I changed the ID after I came to the United States, that I am not a teacher anymore over there in Egypt. هو ده الID. يعني in that, I just needed to finish that. And until now, it is not changed in that. Until now, in that ID, I am a teacher in in that village, in that town. They just need a paper that he's not teaching anymore. That's it. إخلاء طرف يا عم دكتور. Just to say, this guy is not working anymore for us. They don't want to give you that one. I was still working there. Was no salary. Yeah, when you go, get, طب give me the salary. لا, انت مش working. طب right for you, you're not working. خلاص يعني, الله أعلم. Now if you go, said, where is your file? You don't have a file here. طب مش American citizen. يا أخي روح America, go, go. Why are you coming here? Allah Azza wa Jal has rahma on this ummah, as I mentioned in the beginning. So Allah make many things easy for us. Also, it tells us, subhanAllah, also it tells us how the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, they understood those stories and they act differently. Allah Azza wa Jal told us about Bani Israel, about the Saturday and how they transgressed in the fishing, right? Then Allah tested the Sahaba of Rasulullah with the side. when they were going for the Hajj, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Allah will test you with the game. You know, the game will come close to you. تَنَالُهُ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَرِمَاحُكُمْ لِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَخَافُهُ بِالْغَيْبِ. So you can catch it with your hand and with your spear, you can do like this. But they did not do it. They did not fall in the, they did not fail in the test and in the exam. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also the Sahaba, he trained his Sahaba that, you know, if you do something and you want to fix it, you should ask. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla will expose, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expose the munafiqeen, right? In the Quran, يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مَعَهُمْ إِذْ يُبَيِّتُونَ. يعني, when they are making affairs, Allah Azza wa Jalla brings. So the Sahaba knew that they have to be open for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this hadith, mashallah, it is a very beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Next time, inshallah, we'll take a newer hadith, hadith number 59, also in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, about business deals and how it should be truthful and honest for Allah's sake. And this is the key for the barakah to come in any business transaction that we do. Instead of focusing on the profit only, the material profit, think about that. Profit with Allah Azza wa Jal. Yeah, this trade will make profit for you to live. But that's then the final goal. That is one of the objectives to help the final goal. I want to sell, I want to make money so I can make profit. Why you want to make profit? So I can live better life. Why you want to live a better life? To become a better Muslim. So that's your goal. To become a better Muslim, you cannot be a better Muslim with suht, with transgression, with haram. You see how the equation is? So your business, you ask yourself, why I'm making that business? To make profit. Great. Why are you making that profit? To live a better life. Why you want to live a better life? To become a better Muslim and the servant of Allah. That should be in your head first. What I'm doing now, transaction, it helps me to be servant of Allah or helps me be a greedy person? So you have to be truthful and honest. Inshallah, we'll talk about that next time. Sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.